metabolic activities of all the living cells not only provide energy for growth, repair and maintenance of tissue, but also result in the production of waste products which must be excreted out of the body. Hence, the waste products require the special services of kidney for their excretion. Kidney and associated organs that take part in the formation and excretion of urine are combinedly termed as urinary system, which is otherwise called as excretory system. So students, let us discuss about the excretory system.
Organs of the renal system. As you can see in this picture, the organs of the urinary system consist of two kidneys, two ureter, one urinary bladder and one urethra, through which the urine is discharged from the urinary bladder to the exterior. Kidneys which secretes urine, ureters which convey the urine from the kidneys to urinary bladder, urinary bladder where urine collects and is temporarily stored, urethra through which the urine is discharged from the urinary bladder to the exterior. Next, we shall discuss about the structure and functions of kidneys. The kidneys are located in the posterior part of the abdomen, one on each side of the vertebral column. Vertebral column, as you may already know, is a column formed of a series of bones called vertebrae, forming the axis of the skeleton and protecting the spinal cord. The kidneys are described as the bean-shaped organs surrounded by the renal fat. Let us study about the structure of kidneys in detail. Our bean-shaped kidneys are enclosed in capsule. Underlying the capsule, we may find the external part of the kidney known as renal cortex. The inner part is known as medulla. Medial to the medulla is a fissure which is known as the hilum of the kidney. Here you can see the hilum. Hilum in general is the part of a kidney where the blood vessels and nerves enter. At the hilum, the renal artery and renal nerves enter the kidney and renal vein leaves the kidney, as you can see. To further understand how our kidneys work, let us have a look at the microscopic structure of the kidneys. Here we shall focus on the basic unit of kidney, that is the nephron, which is responsible for the kidney's functioning. Let us get to know a bit more about these structures of nephron. Glomerulus, it is the main filter of the nephron and lies within the Bowman's capsule. The glomerular capsule forms a cup-like structure and is a thin double membrane enclosing the glomerulus. The main function of the glomerulus is to filter the waste products from the blood and thus initiate urine formation. Proximal convoluted tubule or proximal tubule, which is the most proximal part of the renal tubule which lies in the cortex. Once the glomerular filtrate passes through the opening into the Bowman's capsule, it goes through the PCT, from where it passes through the loop of Henle and the distal tubule. Loop of Henle. The loop of Henle is a long U-shaped part of the renal tubule extending through the medulla from the end of the PCT to the beginning of the DCT. It begins with a descending limb having a thick walled segment called the proximal straight tubule, followed by a thin walled segment called a thin or attenuated tubule. This is followed by the ascending limb, which sometimes includes the distal end of the attenuated tubule and always ends with a long thick walled segment called distal straight tubule. The loops vary in the lengths of their segments according to their locations in the kidney. It is also called as ansa nephroni and it is responsible for carrying urine out of the nephron. Distal convoluted tubule or distal tubule, DCT, a distal rolled together or coiled part of the ascending limb of the renal tubule. It lies in the cortex. The urine from here passes into the collecting duct. Collecting duct or tubules. A long straight portion after the distal tubule is the open end of the nephron. It extends from the cortex down through the medulla. These are responsible for collecting urine from DCT of the nephron and passing it to the renal pelvis. These are also of two types, proximal straight tubule and distal straight tubule. Let us see the physiological functions of kidney. First, keep the concentrations of various ions and other important substances constant. A number of chemicals are important to the blood chemistry, such as potassium, sodium, phosphorus, calcium, magnesium, and chlorate. The healthy kidneys ensure the right amounts of these in the blood. Second, keep the volume of water in the body constant by removing excess fluid from the body. The kidneys regulate the volume of extracellular fluid by eliminating or retaining water. The reabsorption of water in the tubules is controlled by pituitary and hypothalamic actions. The posterior pituitary produces antidiuretic hormone, which increases the amount of water reabsorbed. The adrenal cortex produces the hormone aldosterone, which influences the reabsorption sodium and water. Regulate the osmolarity of extracellular fluid by regulating the amount of sodium chloride and water excreted. Remove the waste from the body. Many metabolic waste products such as urea, uric acid, ammonia, and creatinine need to be filtered or removed from the body by the kidneys. Keep the acid-base concentration of the blood constant and regulate the blood pressure. Renin, an enzyme-like substance of the kidney, helps in converting angiotensinogen to angiotensin, which is responsible for producing vascular constriction, thereby increasing the blood pressure. It also stimulates the secretion of aldosterone from the adrenal glands and causes sodium and water to be retained, increasing blood volume and blood pressure. Stimulate the making of red blood cells. Erythropoietin is a hormone responsible for maintaining the right amount of RBC count in the body by stimulating the bone marrow to make more RBCs. The last function of kidney is maintain the body's calcium levels. Along with parathormone and calcitriol, kidney helps the body to absorb calcium. The work of the kidney centers on maintaining the normal composition, volume, and pH of body fluids. In accomplishing this task, each kidney removes from the blood variable amounts of water, organic and inorganic constituents, as well as toxic substances, and eliminates these in the urine. The main function of the kidney is the formation of urine through a series of varying activities. Urine is amber-colored transparent liquid having specific gravity of 1.002 to 1.040. A normal healthy adult excretes about 1 to 1.5 liters of urine per 24 hours, having mainly water, besides urea, inorganic salts and organic constituents. The kidneys form urine in three phases: simple filtration, selective reabsorption, and secretion. Simple filtration. The process of filtration takes place in the nephron, where approximately 10% of the blood which the kidney receives gets filtered under pressure through the walls of the glomerular capillaries and Bowman's capsule. The filtrate is composed of water, ions, example sodium, potassium and chloride, glucose and small proteins. The rate of filtration is approximately 125 ml per minute or 180 liter each day. The semi-permeable wall of the glomerulus act as a filter. It allows the blood constituents having a molecular weight less than 68,000, such as water, food substances like glucose and amino acids, inorganic salts, waste products like urea, uric acid and creatinine, etc., to pass through. It retains the larger molecules like red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets and plasma proteins, etc. These high molecular weight substances are unable to pass through the semi-permeable membrane of the glomerulus. Glomerular filtration rate, which is abbreviated as GFR. The kidneys receive a large amount of blood flow. The kidney blood flow is approximately 1200 ml per minute. 1/10 of this is filtered as the blood flows through the glomeruli, that is about 120 ml. The glomerular filtrate is formed by squeezing out the fluid through the glomerular capillary bed. The driving hydrostatic pressure That is, the pressure exerted by a liquid as a result of its potential energy is controlled by the afferent and efferent arterioles. The glomerular filtration rate decreases with age and disease. Selective reabsorption. The purpose of this process is to reabsorb those constituents of the filtrate which are essential to the body. By this reabsorption, the composition and volume of the filtrate is altered, fluid and electrolyte balance of the body is maintained. The specialized cells of the tubules selectively reabsorb the constituents of the filtrate as they pass through the tubule. Plasma substances like glucose, amino acids and vitamin C are reabsorbed under normal circumstances. They have a high threshold value, but there is a limit to it. If the blood glucose is within 120 mg per 100 ml of blood, then all the glucose in the filtrate is reabsorbed. If it exceeds 180 mg per 100 ml of blood, some glucose appears in the urine. This occurs in the case of diabetes mellitus. A major portion of the waste products like ammonia, creatinine and sulfates are not reabsorbed but excreted. These substances have low threshold values. In between these high threshold substances and low threshold substances, there are some substances which are reabsorbed according to the need of the body. For example, the reabsorption of inorganic salts depends upon the plasma level of the substances. Let us briefly look into the active and passive reabsorption. Specialized protein called transporters are located on the membranes of the various cells of the nephron. These transporters grab the small molecules from the filtrate as it flows by them. Some transporters require energy, usually as ATP, which is active transport, while others don't require energy, which is passive transport. Both passive and active reabsorption of molecules from the nephron to the blood occurs at the PCT, that is proximal convoluted tubules of the nephron. Next, we move on to the third and last phase in the process of urine formation, that is secretion. In the process of filtration through the glomerulus, the non-threshold substances and drugs that are not cleared from the blood because the blood does not remain for a long time in the glomerulus. Such substances are secreted into the convoluted tubules and cleared from the blood. These substances include para-aminohippuric acid and penicillin, etc. They pass from the blood into the urine.